In this quick video, we're going to talk about REST API design, and we're going to specifically focus on the discussion around nouns versus verbs in the URI space. Let's get this started with the nouns versus verbs discussion, and we're going to hit a few points here, starting with the fact that the URI structure of a solid API should be as meaningful and as predictable as possible. So the idea is to have something that a user and a client of that API can reasonably guess and predict and easily understand. And that usually leads to a very clean, very well-structured API namespace. One of the core concepts of any REST API is that an API is resource-centric. So it mainly deals with resources and with operations on those resources. So how do we represent those operations? Very simply put, operations or verbs are represented not in the URI, but via HTTP verbs on resources. So what that means is that we are leveraging the HTTP protocol with its full semantics. We're not using HTTP as a transport protocol. We are using it as what it's meant to be, an application level protocol with a rich set of semantics. And so there is no need to have a verb in the URI because we have verbs available for us in the HTTP spec. And so the URI will remain clean of verbs and will only have nouns representing resources. So if you're just starting off with API design, or even if you've done a couple of APIs, this is a great rule of thumb that I use as a general driver of any API decision I make. And that is that a verb in the URI is always a design smell, which means that we have a good trigger signal and a good opportunity to improve the design of the API. And that usually means some domain modeling. It basically means that we have not done enough work extracting out the domain of our application into resources. So let's have a look at a practical example. This is, of course, a very simplistic example, but quite representative of the kind of API design decision we'll need to make day in and day out. So we are trying to make a payment, and this would be a typical URI structure that you could see in an older RPC style of API. So we would have account/pay. However, now that we know that pay, being a verb, is a clear signal that something is problematic with this URI structure and that we need to put some extra work into our domain and into our general URI structure, let's see how to model this better. So the pay operation now becomes a payment resource. So we are essentially creating a new payment in the system. So we should post to account/payment, and this is now a noun and no longer a verb. So we have extracted a new resource out of the domain of our application, and that new resource is payment. And of course, this will have positive implications across the API. So we're not only going to do a post here, we will be able to take payments, we will be able to list payments, we will be able to potentially delete a payment, although that may not be such a good idea in a banking sort of application. But the point is, we will be able to have other verbs and other operations on this new resource that we have extracted. If you want to learn more about RESTful API design, you should definitely check out course number 2 from REST with Spring. Thank you, and see you in the next video.